Good morning. Good morning, all. It's good to be back here. It's good to. It's a kale kind of a day. And I am James Sanders, Jr., and I'm the chair of banking. And we are going to have some fun this morning. My rancor, is anything that you would like to say, sir?
Well, I will not eating or drinking kale today, but I commend you for that. Other than that, maybe not the only thing we disagree on today. So.
Well, may this be the only.
That's right. May this be, yes.
The only thing. I would ask if that's a Republican position, but I won't. But I won't. It's good to be here. We have Senator Tedesco, Senator Clear, Senator Bridgeport. Well,
that's close.
Well, I was just about there. It was a bridge too far. Bridgeport. And we have Sam Fine, who's kind enough to take the records and make sure that we do all of these things. So while I still have a committee, Sam, would you mind reading the first bill?
S-666 by Senator Kavanaugh, an act to amend the banking law and civil practice law and rules in relation to licensing consumer debt collectors.
If there's a question, comment, or statement.
If I may.
Yes.
You know, I know a lot of folks in this space, and let me tell you, nobody hates bad actors more than those that are following the rules. That being said, there's a lot of duplication of regulation here, registering. You already have other agencies that are requiring registration and regulation. And this is just one of those things, honestly, that's going to, most of the people that are in this space, in this service, are small businesses. About 80% in New York State are small businesses. So I just think it's another onerous regulation on small businesses. I realize there are people out there that don't like the idea of having to collect debt when someone doesn't pay it. But that being said, we want to have good actors in that space. There's already heavy regulation on them. I think that to me, this is just, unfortunately, another bridge too far. So.
Well. Seems a lot of that this morning.
Yeah.
Is there any other question, comment, or statement on this bill? A motion to accept.
Second.
It has been second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay.
Nay.
All without rec. The bill passes and goes to finance.
S-1450 by Senator Sanders. An act to amend the banking law and the administrative code of the City of New York in relation to regulating commercial finance licensing, establishing the Minority and Women-Owned Business Protection Program.
I know the sponsor, he's usually does good stuff. Is there a question, comment, or statement on this bill? I see a motion.
Oh, second. Sir.
I see a second. All in favor say aye.
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 All opposed say nay.
Nay.
Name. Put that in the record. All without rec. Please. It's in the record. The bill passes and goes to finance.
Don't worry, the next time I'm going to redeem myself.
Okay, I'm looking for redemption. Yes, sir, Sam, please.
S-1690 by Senator Sanders. An act to amend the banking law and the New York State Urban Development Corporation Act in relation to the Capital Access Program.
Question, comments, or statements on this bill?
I happen to know the sponsor, fine gentleman. I would like to move the bill, if I may.
So. It's moved.
Second.
And a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. All without rec. The bill passes and goes to finance. The next one, we are pulling this bill, I believe.
Yes.
All right. The next bill, sir. The Thomas bill.
S-5056 by Senator Thomas. An act to amend the financial services law in relation to creating a private education debt registry.
Questions, comments, or statements?
Move the bill.
It has been motioned and second. Motion second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay.
Nay.
Got two nays, yes. At least. The bill passes and goes to finance. A lot going to finance today. Ready when you are, sir.
S-6270 by Senator Sanders. An act to amend the banking law in relation to criteria for the establishment of banking development districts.
I'll say something here. We really have to work on the issue of banking districts. We have to figure out how to make these things more effective. They're not providing the desired end that we're looking for. They're not pulling the banks to our communities, and we really need to work on it. Are we using enough money? Maybe we need to incentivize these more. Whatever we do, we need to start thinking about it and figure out how do we make these districts more competitive, that's word. Any questions, comments? Yes, ma'am.
Banking district, what is that?
Oh, well,
I'm not, you know, I
got a problem. I actually can answer that.
Okay.
A banking district is a vehicle that was created to try to encourage banks to come to different areas, underbanked communities. And it has been used. At first, there was some positive impact, but recently it had not played the issue, not played the role that we wanted. Some of the banks are saying it's not enough money. You're not putting enough to make it worth our time and effort, if you wish.
The money is put into where to do what?
Okay.
Exactly.
You're a good question. It comes from the state, of course. This is these state funds that are put into these usually, well, I was about to say smaller, but that's not often the case. Put into banks. If a bank moved into your district, let's say, the state would incentivize it by giving a certain amount of money. If you move into your part of Harlem, we'll give you a certain amount of state money that you can hold for us. And well, Harlem has some unique.
We had no banks.
Well, no, you guys have some unique vehicles up there. You've got the enterprise zones, et cetera, that are probably more effective bringing the banks. But other communities, we need to use them for other communities, and we need to use every tool in our toolbox, and we have to look at it because these are the tools we have.
So you promised the bank a certain amount of money.
Yes.
They'll give you money to hold for us if you move into these areas.
Yes.
That are underbanked.
Yes.
Like Senator Morello's community.
Yes.
This is an issue in rural areas as well. Absolutely. And I think, and by the way, I've asked to be signed on to both of these bills. I think this is great. I mean, let's keep in mind that, you know, banks don't just take the money and stick it in a vault somewhere. They lend that money.
Right,
that's the job, right?
Right.
For us to take state money and put it into areas where now that money's on the street, supporting small businesses, car loans, mortgages, that's important.
It
gives a community that may not be able to financially support a bank with enough capital to do those things, with the ability to do it using state funding without it being a subsidy. We have to put our money somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So this makes a lot of sense.
Might as well put it there.
Yes.
Okay.
So this makes a lot of sense. Mm-hmm. I'm happy to support both of these bills.
We really
Chairman,
need
you know,
to.
Banks are businesses.
Yes.
And they're for profits.
Yes.
And they have investors.
Yes.
And they don't exist if the investors aren't successful with their investments. This reminds me of why we can't get broadband. You know, you live on a street, and when they want to provide that broadband, it costs them money. And there's not enough people to provide for it. So what's the answer to that? You know, holistically, we promised they'd all have broadband access. And that impacts our businesses, too.
It does.
You know.
It does. You could actually look at broadband through the lens of banking, or any of these come under a banking committee. However, this bill itself is saying that we need to look at the tools that we have. We've been given some tools. How do we use them more effectively? How do we say, I don't know, there has to be an MWBE or it has to, we can be creative here. We can say, if you go to the rural communities, you can even get more money or whatever it takes. We can be creative. We should think out of the box to deal with this. I would encourage everybody to speak to the banks also. Get their ideas. Doesn't mean that we're going to do it. It doesn't. It means that we will be impacted. These guys have spent a lot of time on these issues. We should hear what everybody is saying. The credit unions, the CDFIs, all kinds of stuff that's out there. Let's get their ideas and let's do something. But to do nothing means that our communities just, you know, fade away. And we're, nobody at this table is here to do nothing. We are here to try to figure out what's the right thing, but we're not going to do nothing. We'll study it first.
So you're saying that they didn't take into consideration whether or not the community was underbanked or unbanked when establishing these districts?
No, the opposite. They cannot establish it without a study saying that it is an unbanked area.
No, I'm saying that's what you're asking, but
I'm saying that we need to go further into this study and read. It has not really been looked at probably in more than 10 years.
It's from 97, is
it? Yeah, we more than that. We haven't looked at this issue of, we put it out there. We need to see how do we make it more effective.
Okay.
And that's what we're here about. Having said that, I'll accept a motion.
I'll move the bill.
Has it been motioned?
Second.
And then have a second. Let the record show it's bipartisan.
Yes.
There's a bridge there.
Yeah. Yeah. Bridge, not a bridge.
Small bridge.
I think we need to vote on it.
Everyone knows we need these things. Why do we need a vote? We all already agree. Thank you, sir. That's why I have you sit right there. You're right. You moved on up. Now on, he sits there. Or it had been moved in second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. All without rec. Congratulations to all. And this is one that we don't have to send to finance. Two we don't have to.
Yeah.
All right, the bill is passed. Sir, take us to the next one.
S-6271 by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the banking law in relation to minority depository institutions which apply to establish a home or branch office in an unbanked or underbanked community.
We're further expanding, same basic idea. How do we get monies to communities that have been historically underbanked? Questions, comments, or statements? I'll take a motion. They have been motioned. And second, Senator Tedesco. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. All without record. The bill has been passed and will go to finance. The last bill, sir.
S-6648 by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the banking law in relation to including participation in a banking development district as a factor when assessing a banking institution's record of performance.
Now here's where we get bold. We're saying that the banks are out there and they get graded every year or so, but we need to see, are they trying to go into these communities also? Why don't we include that as part of the grade? Are you going into these communities? When was the last time they went into wherever? Let's encourage these guys.
I would just say that I appreciate the spirit of it, and I like the, you know, we have the carrot and the stick idea. We, you know, the carrot of the two previous bills. I do have some concerns, though, that this may be a little too onerous for some folks. I'm going to be AWR on this because I appreciate the spirit, but I would encourage you to do just what you said earlier. Let's talk to the banks. Let's talk to those folks and see if there's a way to improve this so that I love the idea of an incentive and maybe even some kind of a performance metric, but let's just make sure it's not too onerous. That's only my caution.
Worthy, I suspect that before I walk out of this room, one or two banks will be kind enough to give me encouragement.
All right. Yes.
All right, any more questions, comments, or statements?
Move the bill.
It's motion second. And second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. All without rec.
Not rec.
Without rec.
All right. My friends, I appreciate the bill passing. I appreciate the, what's even more important to me is the spirit that we do these meetings where we are is not just going through it. We're actually trying to figure things, things that will help the people of New York State for decades to come, God willing. So this is a very crazy day, and I'm sure all of you have got a bunch of stuff. I appreciate you taking the time. This committee hearing is now closed.